The CDFW hatchery programs play a critical role in salmon, both from a conservation standpoint and for fisheries. Somewhere between 40% and 65%, depending on the year, of the fish caught in the salmon fisheries come from hatcheries. It's been estimated by a recent study that the economic impact for salmon fisheries in California is $1.4 billion, and it creates approximately 23,000 jobs. All four salmon hatcheries that produce fall run Chinook in the Central Valley, their annual budget total is around $12 million. So that's a pretty amazing return on investment. So some of our release strategies that are aimed specifically at improving ocean fisheries include trucking fish to net pens that are actually in the ocean. These fish will be dropped off by a hatchery truck into a net pen. They'll sit there for anywhere from several hours to up to a week, depending on the location. Those fish are intended specifically to increase ocean fish landings. One of the new strategies that we've been looking at is doing direct nighttime releases to help avoid avian predation. And we're really seeing a lot of success from those types of release strategies in the returns from coded wire tag data we collect. We've also been experimenting with fry releases. So releasing fish at a much smaller stage when water conditions are significantly improved, water's colder, flows are higher, gives fish a chance to get down further in the system.
Wide open fishing.
Wide open, awesome. Good to see. From the conservation perspective, we have hatcheries that are literally keeping fish on the landscape that would be extinct without the hatchery programs, doing gravel injection of eggs in habitat that in some cases haven't had fish in them for more than 100 years. Putting fish above dams, hatchery programs are supporting reintroduction efforts. We probably wouldn't be having salmon fisheries if it weren't for our hatcheries.